Hi friends, this is Satvik. Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to cover about network layer and transport layer. Wait, Satvik, what are these layers? For the people who don't understand what are this layer and what I'm talking about, please find the link of my playlist in the description. You can watch through my previous videos. You can get some more idea and more clarity on what I'm talking right now. Actually, these are the part of OSI model. So OSI model have 7 layers, and I discussed about 2 layers in my previous video and what are the uses of OSI model. I discussed a lot of stuff in this previous video. So if you didn't watch those videos, please go and watch those videos and come back here. You will get some more idea and some more clarity, and you can understand this particular video more clearly. Without any late, let's start our video. So you can see here, this is the OSI model and it consists of 7 layers. In previous video, we discussed briefly about all layers, but we covered deeply in about data link layer and physical layer. In this video, we are going to cover about layer 3 and layer 4, that is network layer and transport layer, right? So what is a network layer? I kept this some description regarding here about network layer and also some functionalities of network layer, but in nutshell, I will explain everything. Please don't focus more on the content on the screen. Please focus to my voice. You can understand more and more clearly. Network layer is nothing but it just use it to transfer the packets from host to the receiving host. That's it. What will network layer do means it just simply transfer your packets. It move your packets from your computer or your PC to the other PC. Maybe it is within your network or it may be existing any other net. How network layer works, everything we will discuss. And more importantly, you have to understand is in network layer, the most important thing is routing. Routing means I discussed about router and routing in my previous videos, right? So router simply forwards the data packet from your network to the other network. In simple words, router do routing. And routing means it's simply forwarding your packet, data packet. If you want to communicate with friend in other network, or if you want to communicate friend in some far distant area, maybe he will be in different network, right? So what router will do means your packet, your data will be sent through that router, and the router will forward that packet to the other router. So on it will go and reaches your friend. So this is what actually router do. It's do routing, okay? And router is called as also a layer 3 device, okay? There are some protocols in network layer. We discussed about IP address, right? It is a unique name assigned to a particular device which is in a network, right? So even IP address is also IP protocol that comes under in this network layer only. We will get some more idea about network layer by talking about those functions. So first of all, as I explained before, routing. So routing, you understand it? Okay, now logical addressing. So what is logical addressing? Previously explained, right? So there is a physical address, that is MAC address, okay? And logical address means IP address. Remember one thing, in data link layer, we used physical address, that is MAC address, and that is used by switch, okay? In network layer, where in layer 3, we use router, it is used to do routing, and it use logical address. Physical address means it a MAC address. Logical address means it's IP address. So okay, so here in this network layer, the main functionality is about providing logical address. Okay, next thing is internetworking. Internetworking means the main role of the network layer, that it provides the logical connection between different types of networks. See, previously we talked about routing, right? So what happened in routing? Different networks will be connected in a single way. A device in a particular network can transfer the data to the device in the other network. So this internetworking will be the functionality of the network layer. And when coming to the fragmentation. So the fragmentation is the process of breaking the packets into the smallest individual data units that travel through the different networks. All this happen in the network layer. So in simple words, network layer used to do transfer the data or move the data from one host to another host. It will be done by routing. It uses logical address, that is IP address, and internetworking will be there, and also the fragmentation of data. The data will be fragmented, so it will break down into the smaller individual data packets, and those data packets will be traveled through the networks. I think you got some idea and some clarity on functions of network layer. So in simple words, this is network layer, okay? So now coming to the big topic, that is a transport layer, and we have many number of books are also there in only particular this topic. So I will try to explain within very clearly in a simple manner. So please understand understand this clearly. If you have any doubt, please do comment also. The main role of the transport layer is to provide the communication services directly to the application process running on different hosts. So in simple words, it actually provides the service what TCP or UDP. So actually these are two protocols mainly used in transport layer. Maybe one who wants to learn about networking surely listened about these two protocols, TCP or UDP. Actually our phone call is there, right? It will use user datagram protocol. When coming to the internet, it maximum uses TCP, transmission control protocol. So what these two protocols and what this particular layer will do means, it actually provides you communication services directly to the application process. So if you want to communicate with your friend, right, from your browser, you are open Facebook and your friend also open Facebook in his browser. So your browser is an application in your host and browser in your friends is also an application at his host. Okay, right? So what will happen? So all the data packets will become to the network layer. Before that, transport layer provides communication service directly to the application. Here browser is an application and their browser is an application. So these communication will be provided by the transport layer. So a transport layer provides a logical communication between application process running on different hosts. So I think you got it right. Right. So in simple words, this is actually, it is a big stuff, and TCP UDP are the biggest protocols ever we talked about in networking. Okay. So when coming to the functionalities, end-to-end delivery, addressing will be there, reliable delivery, flow control, multiplexing, there are a lot of transport layer services are there. So here you can see application layer, we will talk about this later. In internet layer, internet layer means the three layers which are at the bottom of the OSM model is called internet layer. So see here, you can get some clear idea. Some applications use TCP and some applications use UDP, right? So this will happen and from there it will get into the IP, internet layer. And when coming to the functions of transport layer, so end-to-end delivery. Okay, so here one end there is one application and other end there is another application. That end-to-end delivery will be happen through the transport layer. Addressing also will be happen through the transport layer. Reliable delivery means if some packet lost in middle, then what will happen means it automatically transfers again based on the acknowledgements received by it. So there is a better and reliable transportation has been happened because of this transport layer. Flow control, so we will discuss about flow control in previous video when discussing about data link layer, right? So same thing happened in transport layer also. The flow will be controlled by the transport layer while transferring the data through the network. So multiplexing is a big topic. We will cover about multiplexing in one particular video. I think you got some clear idea about network layer and transport layer. When coming to the summary, I will explain it in a very clear manner. In a nutshell, network layer is used to simply move data from one host to another host. Okay, the functionalities of networking layer is providing logical addressing, it uses for routing. Those things will be internetworking will also will be there in network layer. So all these will be controlled by networking layer. Okay, network layer. So router is a network layer or layer 3 device. It uses IP address, it do routing based on the IP address. So it is logical addressing. This is completely about network layer in a brief manner. When coming to the transport layer, it is used to transport the data from one particular application in one host to the another particular application in another host. Those transport will be completely managed and under monitored by the transport layer. There are two protocols, TCP and UDP. One is transmission control protocol and one is user datagram protocol. So both are the most, mainly TCP uses the most and UDP has some part in internet. So these two will be most implemented protocols and most useful protocols currently in the internet. Okay, what will happen means the transport layer controls the flow and it is a reliable connection. The data will be, any data loss, the connection will be reconnected and it will transfer the data again. So, and it is end-to-end delivery kind of stuff. So this is about transport layer in brief manner. I hope this video helpful for you and I think you learned something new today. I want to get into the practical mode as fast as I can. That's why I'm explaining theoretical stuff in very very quick manner. If you want more idea, if you want more clarity, so please watch, more number of videos are there in YouTube. You can learn more knowledge also from there. Okay, right. In next video, we are going to talk about application, presentation and session layer. If you know about TCP and UDP, please do comment below and stay tuned for more videos. Like, share, comment and do subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to turn on notification bell. Thank you, friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. See you back in the next video.